Should be live in a couple of seconds. Right. Okay, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, where you are in the world. My name is Adrien Jones, and here we are, just the post fight for, hold on, let's fix that, that's not right. That's better. Don't know what happened there. Right, the post fight video for Broner versus Ashley Theophane. Few things coming into this fight. I think everyone knew about Ashley Theophane and the Broner fight in terms of everyone's making a big fuss about Broner not making the weight. You know, I am not surprised in the slightest when it comes to Adrien Broner. He seems to be a law unto his own self. But everyone seemed to be shocked that Broner was going to not make the weight. I mean, let's be honest, apart from the outside dramas to this fight, in Broner's life otherwise, to be honest, there wasn't really much interest in this fight. You know, the play between Broner and Floyd Mayweather, let's also be honest about that, that's been going on for quite a while now. They had to build some sort of beef between the pair of them, the beef between Berto and Mayweather. Whether it was real or not, I don't know. But Andre Berto got paid well. As for now, this storyline between Adrien Broner and Floyd Mayweather, it's been a story that's been building a while. You know, they're best of buddies. They're, you know, little bro looks up to big bro. And then Broner's done a few things that big bro has not been really, you know, hasn't taken kindly to. I mean, big bro himself isn't really exactly the role model, but anyway, it is what it is. We get previews to what happens in fights now because boxing is in such a poor, not a great state at the moment, that we have to have these fake rivalries and fake grudge matches. And then we wonder why we don't get the intensity that and people are disappointed because it's not real. But anyway, I digress. Ashley Theophane, no disrespect to Ashley. He's a basic fighter. And again, no disrespect. You respect any man that gets in the ring and boxes. But to be really honest, I never understood why he was in TMT. Camp. I didn't understand why I was in a TMT camp then. I don't know why he's in the camp now, and I'm not sure what he'll do in the camp later. Never thought he was a good fighter. I thought he was a decent fighter, just a decent fighter, but I never knew why he was in the camp. Maybe he made for good sparring, but you know, there was no way in absolute hell that Ashley Theophane was going to win the fight. There was no way that Ashley Theophane was going to beat Adrien Broner. Absolutely no way. You know, first of all, Theophane doesn't hit hard enough. And then secondly, you know, every time Adrien wanted to hit him, he was there to be hit. So he's a very basic fighter. Just basically, Broner was sucking it up, taking what he had to take on the gloves. And then, when ready, unloaded the punch that he did. Yes, I admit it definitely was a low blow that he hit Theophane with. Definitely was a low blow. But, you know, the writing was on the wall. And Broner did the job and stopped the fight. You know, he's talking about, you know, he's going to have to come and see me. And, you know, either we have a spar or we have you know, a fight, but come on. If you're really that much of a bad man, you have to wait until, you know, Floyd Mayweather was right there over the, on the ring apron. He said, "Oh, you're gonna have to see me." I mean, he just didn't see. He just seemed all choreographed, and even Floyd's looking at him and laughing and smiling and clapping as if to say, "Okay, let's see if you can hype this fight. Let's see how much you can hype this fight." You know, that's what he's looking at, and laughing and smiling at him. You know, because all Floyd's looking at is money. My 50th fight. Who can I make the most money out of for my 50th fight? You know, who can it be? Can it be Pacquiao? Can it be Broner? Can it be Danny Garcia? Well, that three of them, you know, Pacquiao hits the hardest between the three of them. Then you've got Danny Garcia, who's got a left hook but flat-footed. And you've got Adrien Broner. You know, Broner's flat-footed himself. He's undisciplined. And he's easy to hit. So, you know, you've got the Danny Garcia fight, but once you take the left hook away from Danny Garcia, and he doesn't even look that good at welterweight. So out of the three fights, you know, of the three guys who would sell a fight, Broner's the guy that would sell a fight for 50th fight. Flat-footed, big mouth, you know, always talked about Mayweather versus Broner, what would happen. So there you got your fight there. So there's your 50th fight. You know, even it makes me even wonder. I go back to think about the Maidana fight, the first fight, Floyd. He didn't have to sit on the ropes against Maidana, you know, and stand and go toe-to-toe with Maidana. In the second fight, he made the fight pretty easy. Kind of wonder, well, the first fight, did he say, yeah, I can get two fights out of this guy. I can actually get two fights out of this guy. Get it close. I ain't going to beat on the cards. And then have rematched the guy and then just completely outbox him. I don't know. I don't know. So it is what it is. Let's see. We've got some people in the room. Wow, you're up late, says Terence Trump. Feed Khabib says, nice, easy, 50 quid. 6-4, Broner KO, easy money. Definitely easy money. Sergio Jimenez says, no one is here, just me. Sergio Jimenez says, save your voice. Yemi Babantunde, good to see you, Yemi. Hi, Ingram, long time no see. Was this beef real between them? No, boy, you need to cut it. Broner look crap, says Boxing Fan UK. Broner and Mayweather beef, real or manufactured? Absolutely manufactured. Absolutely manufactured. Sergio Jimenez, where are you from? Babatunde, where exactly are you from as well? Fikabi, good to see you in the room. It was all BS, absolutely all BS, totally BS. I mean, you know, it is what it is. That if good to see you, Broner should join TMT. Yeah, he probably will afterwards, and then you know, Broner could be the headman for TMT after Floyd retires for the I don't know how many time. California, big time. California, love Cali, spend time out there. Santa Monica, spent a lot of time in Santa Monica. Loved it out there. Orange County, lovely. Manufacture setup for Mayweather's big 50th return fight. Yeah, of course. In what's your prediction tomorrow night, please? Smith is a cert, but Fielding with Brass could be a decent fight. What can I tell you? Callum Smith, he's all right. I mean, I expect him to beat that guy. As for Rocky Fielding, I don't know. I don't rate his trainer very highly. But I mean, where Brass just comes forward in straight lines. It's like a walking punch bag. What can I tell you? I don't know. Fielding's decent. He'll beat Brass. Fielding's a pretty decent fighter. And he punches pretty hard. His chin was shocking. I don't think Callum Smith. I know Callum Smith's a good puncher. Well, I wouldn't say he's a magnificent puncher, and Fielding got chinned in a round by Callum Smith. So, and I won't say Rabras is a big puncher. I'm from the UK, like you, Ingram, from Lancaster. Okay, Lancaster, nice. Okay, yeah, I'm actually living in Ireland at the moment, not the UK, but I hail from the UK in the beginning. Yeah. So yeah, I'm not totally, you know, I can't tell you that I'm a Broner fan, because I'm not. I think the guy could be three times a better fighter, but it's just the way it is for him. He's doing what he's doing. He might say about billions. I can't see him being a billionaire, to be honest, but I don't know what his court case is or what his situation is with him. I really haven't looked in it. I don't particularly care. To be honest, I don't like Adrien Broner because of what he represents. But to be absolutely honest, I didn't care for Theophane either. It does nothing for me as a fighter. You know, I think Ashley Theophane's a good fighter. He's a decent fighter. But, I mean, what was the stoppage like, James Hay? Austin Broner, Brook for big fight. Eddie keeps on about. Eddie will talk about anything. Eddie Hearn, as far as I'm concerned, cannot deliver the big fights. Not for Kell Brook. Sorry. For him to deliver the big fights, he has to make Kell Brook. Kell Brook has to sign for Al Heyman. I've been saying this for donkey's years. He has to sign with Al Heyman. Eddie Hearn talks a lot, but I don't think he has the. Let me say this way. It's not he hasn't got the budget. I don't think that Matchroom's investments in boxing are as much as people think it is. So what round? Round 9. Thank you, Lance, for that. So, no, I don't think Eddie Hearn can deliver the big fights, the really big fights. Don't think he can. The British fighters, yeah, but when you go to the States and the US fighters, then, you know, they might have paid a bit of money for Martin to come to the UK, you know, but that's going to be an interesting fight itself. There's no guarantee that Anthony Joshua walks away world heavyweight champion unless Mr. Martin's paid a lot of money or Joshua finds a way to fight against Southpaw better than he did in the Olympics. So, yeah, what else for me to talk about? Nick Blackwell, I understand, is recovering. I believe I hear stories that he's actually okay. I just pray that he is. He called that Mayweather money. Will money Mayweather accept? It's easy money, isn't it? Did Broner deserve the win? Says Isaiah Falcon. Yeah. There was no way Ashley Theophane was ever going to win the fight, to be blatantly honest with you. He was never going to win the fight. Ashley Theophane versus Adrien Broner was like one guy who had a water gun and another guy who had a bullet in a gun. And that's what it was. Stoppage was a joke. Ashley was telling the ref about a low blow, not saying to stop the fight. I agree with that point. Definitely J8-1. I agree about that. But what I will also say is that Theophane would have been stopped. You know, it was only a matter of time he would have been stopped. Every time Broner connected cleanly on Theophane, it looked like he could stop him. I couldn't stay awake, says Benjamin Berger. Yeah, well, I understand. I was kind of falling asleep as well. The fight was still over. Yeah, I agree, Lance. The fight was definitely over. I was still kind of falling. I was just dropping off watching that. Earlier on in the night, I liked Easter. He looked pretty tasty, that right hand. Very tasty, right hand. Looked good. And the guy before that, I think he's got 15 knockouts. He looked pretty decent. The only thing I was concerned about him, if somebody can give me his name again, the poor lad, it's boxing is fixed. It's not the same anymore. Well, Ashley was getting beat back. Yeah, he was. Let's be honest. Issa did look good. The guy before that, the puncher, could please somebody give me his name, the gentleman's name again. Is it Javonte, wasn't it? What do you make of the Mayweather prospect? Mind me of Gamboa. Which one? Javonte? Yeah, I'm just talking about him now. I liked him. Seems to have good punching power. If I was correct, he was Javonte Davis. Thank you very much. Was he Southpaw? God knows, I'm tired now. He was Southpaw. He seemed to do little things like Mayweather, you know. His back foot was there, his right hand. Javonte Davis, thank you. The straight right hand looked good. the points I liked about him is he's heavy-handed. He knows how to finish. The uppercuts, the way through uppercuts reminded me of Mike Tyson. Remember Mike Tyson when he fought Bruno for the second time round? He looked really good then when he was able to get into position and kept throwing the uppercuts. That was really sweet. I like that. And he threw three uppercuts, one, two, three at the end. That was nice. Takes a certain amount of class to get a man when you've got him hurt to throw three uppercuts like that. That was very, very nice. I like that. I liked his punch power. He looked very good like that. Javonte, for me, Davis, I like him. What I didn't like is that he keep getting hit with shots. He kept getting hit with shots. That's what concerned me. He kept getting hit with right hands, and you just think to yourself, well, okay, you're doing that against lower level opposition and taking them out. That's nice. But you'll still get, he hit him nine times before the stoppage. And he kept getting hit with the right hand. So my concern with that is that he, good prospect, I don't like the way he's getting caught with the right hand over the top. And it's okay getting caught with the right hand over the top against guys who can't punch. But when you get caught like that against a guy who can punch, there's a concern. Adam Scott says, shit, that it wasn't televised in the UK. It could have watched it live on Spike TV. It was on online, but you could have got it watched it online stream. Lance Easton said he hit him nine times before the stoppage. Yeah, he did. Those three uppercuts were quite vicious, eh, Lance? Danny Alvarez asked Mayweather to come back and fight Broner. Ludicrous or possibility? Big possibility. It looks pretty obvious. I mean, the Berto fight looked obvious. Some beef came out of nowhere. They fought. And this Broner thing's been going on for a while. It'll be interesting to see now Broner's situation. You know, does he get put behind bars? Because obviously, if Davey gets put behind bars, that puts pay to any Mayweather fight. Or does somehow the other Broner situation get sort of sorted out? Nope, you're wrong, Baylor. What am I wrong about? Tell me what I'm wrong about. I saw the fight live, so what are we talking about here? Please. Are you talking about Broner versus Mayweather? Mayweather won't fight him. Do you stream the fights? No, I absolutely don't stream the fights. But if you look at my Twitter page, I did send the link out for the fight tonight. I don't stream it, but I do send the links out if people ask for it. If you don't know, check out Baylorick, Baylorick, boxing, boxin, all one word, Baylorick boxing on Twitter. And the big fights, generally, if people ask for a link, I don't do the links myself. I just find the links online and add them. So if you want to see a live fight, then that's what happens. I do it that way. Will GGG call out Ward? He certainly won't do that. I believe that GGG will stay at middleweight and will look to dominate the middleweight division. Myself and James Elibashir have said it. And if you look at his trainer, hey guys, when is the post-fight press conference? God knows, I don't know. And you know, what is there to talk about? You know, Broner put a beating in Ashley Theophane, and like I said, it was like one guy coming to a gunslinging match with a water gun, and another guy with a bullet. And any time he wanted to let the bullet go, he could do. Is the Mayweather curse real? LOL. Usyk is ducking the Braveheart Simmons. Must have watched the Camacho fight. I spoke to James Elibashir tonight. Funny man. Funny. I spoke to James Elibashir tonight. It looks like Usyk will Usyk will not be fighting, according to Bashir. He will not fight again until the world title fight. He sees no point unless Usyk's promoters think otherwise. The Gamer Freak 720 says Floyd will beat AB because Floyd ain't human, man. The Durham Bull says, Freak says that fight will never happen. Well, never's a strong word in the world of boxing. But I will tell you this much, Durham Bull. I said that Mayweather would fight Pacquiao. Call the year when Mayweather would fight Pacquiao. And people said to me, no, that fight ain't going to happen. I think the fight will happen. I really feel the fight will happen. Think about it. It's 55. Never say never, not in boxing, especially with a fight like that. Broner's flat-footed. I mean, he gets bullied at welterweight. And as you know, Floyd's fought right up at light middle. But I believe it'll happen. I believe the fight will happen. I believe that Broner, like explained early on, he's flat-footed. He's got a big mouth. So he'll sell the fight. And, you know, he's target practice for Floyd Mayweather. So Floyd just gets himself into shape. And then he just beats the crap out of Adrien Broner. Because he knows Adrien Broner. Terence Crawford versus Broner. Now, I don't see that fight happening. Can't see that fight happening, to be honest. That's taking candy from a baby. That's exactly what Floyd would do. Beaver Chops 08 says, I don't see Floyd Broner, man. Too easy. Really? Well, look, well, you wouldn't have thought Floyd would have fought Berto, would you? Floyd Berto? Come on. One fight that won't happen is Fury Vlad rematch. Vlad is going to mess Fury around, then retire. Well, when I spoke to Fury, he looked in decent shape, despite what people were saying on the camera. I sat down and spoke with him in a cafe at Wembley when his cousin Hugh was fighting. So it was me, Peter, Tyson, well, the whole of Team Fury, and myself in EJ Boxing. We sat down in a cafe and a long chat with Tyson. I think the fight will happen. Spence versus Broner, perhaps, but not Mayweather. No, don't think so. Berto was a bum. No, he wasn't a bum. I wouldn't say Berto was a bum. Berto was a good champion. Not great, good champion. Moving forward, Garcia versus Canelo or Khan 2. Depends on the winner or Garcia versus Broner options. I think Garcia fights Mosley. Isn't Mosley going to be fighting for the world title soon? I don't know. But it seems to me Garcia, as long as his dad is in control and he doesn't have any mandatories, he'll be fighting a lot of hand-picked opponents. That's where I think they're going to be. RC513 says, obviously Floyd is more accurate and would probably outpoint AB easy, but I think Broner has more power and could be maybe make it interesting. Has AB got more power than Berto? I would argue that one. Berto is physically a bigger man at welterweight, a natural welterweight, whereas I think AB started his career at lightweight. Shannon Briggs be like, let's go, champ. Beaver Chops 08 says, well, see, though, apparently Broner got some big charges to get through first. Good point. Beaver Chops says, I enjoyed your Fury interview, mate. Thank you very much. What are your predictions for Amir Khan versus Canelo Alvarez? Well, you know what? Weight doesn't make you a better boxer. In the sense, it doesn't make you technically a better boxer. So my thoughts on Canelo Alvarez versus Khan is this. You can be a fan of somebody as much as you want. That doesn't help them have a better inside game. It doesn't help them take a punch any better. And it doesn't help them certain habits. Amir Khan has. Khan doesn't know what to do. He panics when a guy is able to get on the inside of him. You look at the Lamont Peterson fight. You look at the Maidana fight. Look, these are guys that all, you know, Maidana's not the fastest guy in the world, right? And Maidana was able to catch up to Khan and hurt him badly. Diaz dropped him. People think, oh, well, Khan will move up in weight. And if he moves up in weight, then, you know, Khan's going to be okay. But you know what? At lightweight, he moved up to light welterweight. He got chinned by Garcia. He got chinned at lightweight. He got chinned at light welterweight. He got dropped by Diaz as he was moving up to welterweight. He got buzzed by Algieri. Now he's going to move up to Canelo, who was chinned James Kirkland. And I would say James Kirkland hits harder than Khan. So I don't know. I think that Khan could possibly win the early rounds, but I can't see him manhandling the bigger man. And I just think round six onwards, I think Canelo's going to get closer. Khan will tire. Canelo will get inside, land the left hook, and bang. Not to compare, but Berto beat Tim Bradley in amateurs. Berto's not a bum, just bad habits. Thank you very much for that. Are you into MMA or just boxing? Well, I'm into boxing. I can't tell you that I'm a big MMA fan. I can tell you that I'm enjoying watching MMA. You're seeing the best fight the best. But I certainly can get into it. Pete Kavis says, Fury called you out for saying Chisora would beat him. Did you think he was going to flip the table at any point? No, I didn't. We were bantering about that back and forth beforehand. He tried to call me out about it early on when we were walking to the cafe. And I'd done the interview with him, and he called me out about it again. So I said, if he calls me out about it again, I'll talk to him. Not many journalists or bloggers would stand toe-to-toe, not toe-to-toe, sit toe-to-toe with a heavyweight champion of the world and explain their point. My point in case is this. I said to him, the reason why I thought he would be beat by Chisora was because I felt he was vulnerable to the overhand right. And he got dropped by Cunningham, who was a blown-up cruiserweight, or blown-up heavyweight, or cruiserweight. He got dropped by Nevin Pajcek, and he got dropped by somebody else as well. But all the three fights he got dropped, he was at mid-range, and he was susceptible to the overhand right. And actually, Chisora had dropped Kevin Johnson, had dropped Malik Scott, and the overhand right seemed to be a punch that he was doing very well with. So I thought that would be a brilliant punch to throw against Fury. And then he was even getting clipped by, if I was right, was he fight Joe Yabo? Was getting clipped by Joe Yabo, even clipped him as well. So I think to myself, okay, Chisora's got a chance if he can get inside. I remember watching the first fight with Chisora and Fury, thinking to myself, the second fight, if Chisora actually came in shape, it'd be a good fight. Chisora came in shape, and Fury said to me before the fight, I'm going to show you something. And what did he do? He turned southpaw and took the right hand completely away from Chisora. So, you know, and I said to him, look, I actually said that you'd beat Klitschko. He said, I didn't know nothing about boxing. So it was a bad call on Chisora beating Fury. But I said that the big one, Fury beat Klitschko, and I broke it down as to why he'd beat Klitschko. Didn't get a knockout, but I said he'd beat Klitschko, and he did. So that really closed that down. Sugar Shane, please retire, man. Yes. AB won't touch Floyd, says Lance Easton. That referee at the end was who was with AB versus Theophane, looked like the Pink Panther. Funny. MMA's like dogfighting. Can't beat Maidana, or what is his name? I'm sure with a body shot. Khan, for all everyone saying Khan is fast, Maidana is slow. And Khan made Maidana look like Roberto Duran. Okay. Speed, this is speed kills, but I don't believe, in my opinion, that he's going to have the speed against Canelo. I really can't. Early rounds, maybe. But Canelo, once he starts getting inside, Khan's going to have to keep him off for 12 rounds. Can't see it happening. What are your thoughts on AJ versus Martin next week? Well, the only way you can really look into this fight for me is you go back to the amateurs. And if you go back and you look at, everyone keeps talking about his Olympic gold medal. And I keep saying, if you go back to AJ's amateur career and his Olympics, at the Olympics, if AJ had fought anywhere in the world apart from London, he wouldn't be Olympic champion because his performances were not impressive. The previous Olympic champions, Audley Harrison or Jane Segal, their performances, regardless where they were in the world, they'd have been Olympic champion because they boxed their opponents. They did the business. So I'm convinced that AJ will have problems with Martin's left hand. And Martin just doesn't throw a straight left hand. He throws a left hand over the top and drops his head and brings the left hand over top, which would be very dangerous. Oh, very dangerous. Very, very dangerous. So if Joshua, who was much lighter then, was struggling against a left-hander, if him now bigger, being bigger now, so it's slower, is he still going to struggle against a left hand? So, you know, who's he been sparring against as well? Very interesting. I think you'll get more sparring for a right-handed than a left-hander. So it'd be interesting to see how he does. But I'm backing Martin for this one. I did see the gloves are off, and I almost practically fell asleep on it. It was so boring, so boring. Charles Martin, he seems a man that means business. And Joshua's just saying things he normally says. It's good. I think it'd be a good fight. Have you seen the gloves are off with AJ and Martin? See more personality in Fury's Batman costume. Yeah, I agree with you. What's going on with Maidana? He looks in terrible shape. He got a lot of money from Floyd for sure. You think Broner was out of shape today? He did look quite sort of chubby, didn't he? But I thought Broner looked, well, he looked okay. People shocked at Maidana being so fat, forgot Hatton blew up like that between almost every fight. That's true, PKB, very true. I'm an AJ fan, but those Martin odds are very appealing. They are indeed. Steve Bond says, stick a tenner on it, mate. Broner is leaving 140 because Terence Crawford owns the division. Make no mistake. Terence Crawford, if you haven't already, check out my interviews with Terence Crawford. I've got two interviews with Terence Crawford before people start talking about Terence Crawford. Very knowledgeable guy. Knows his way around boxing for sure. The only thing, my only criticism of Terence Crawford, since he's moved up, he hasn't fought any power punches. We'll see what he does against Victor Pistol. I want to see him fight against a power puncher for sure. And once he can fight against a power puncher, and does well against power puncher. But yeah, I'd like to see him do that. That's the final piece in the puzzle for me, for Crawford. Broner is leaving the 140 because Terence Crawford. Yeah, okay. Two thumbs up, B Pepper. I want to see Broner in a post-fight presser. Okay, I can't help you with that one, mate. If you want to do that, I guess just wait until maybe someone like Fight Hype or something loads it up. I can't help with that, unfortunately. Oh, 66. Oh, good number. Yeah. Broner needs to finish work at 140 still. Yeah, I think he does. The fight I'd like to have seen was Broner versus Burns. Ryan Williams, Broner was tired. Yeah, well, for a tired man, he put some punches together quite nicely there, Ryan Williams. But Theophane, he was never high, Brandon Vegas. I didn't think he was tired. I just think he was letting Theophane punch or shoot his water gun. And then when he was ready, lock and load and shoot. Do I think Maidana should have won, but Mayweather won? No, really. Broner announced to his coach, family, and team that he's moving up. That tonight was his last 114. He's moving up. Okay, fine. So he's going back to welterweight. To do what? Glad I never bet on Ashley. What a waste of time. What a waste of... You tell me. You leave England and you're an average fighter. You go to America. You train with Floyd Mayweather's camp. And you come out still an average fighter. I don't understand why people actually believed that he was good enough. I just don't know what the fuss was with Ashley Theophane. Then people actually thought Theophane was going to win the fight. I said Broner was going to smash him to bits. Hey, Jermani Edwards. Did I say the name right? Good evening, Jermani. James Lyons says Broner looked average at best. Well, his opponent was below average. I'd get knocked out by Errol Spence, most likely. Why did the referee stop the fight? Why? It was a low blow. Because Theophane was going to get knocked out. Amanda Conlon, who won? Broner? Yes, he did. Jermani. Am I saying the name right, Jermani? Jermani Edwards says Broner is a beast, hands down. BPBRT, the life. I don't know why that looks. That seems familiar. Broner needs to throw combinations and he will be a force. Yeah, he does. He will be. Yeah, Broner versus Broner versus Floyd. Yes. Yeah, I think so. I think Broner was toying with what's his name, to be honest. If I'm brutally honest, Ashley Theophane had no business being a ring of Adrien Broner. Absolutely none. Yeah, I never saw the hunger from Ashley, and I agree, Broner's a different level. Yeah. 147 is a crazy division, and Broner won't crack the top 10. No, he won't. Yes, it's like the country. Jermani. Okay. Where are you from, Jermani? Which Hov 6 is AB? Anybody can get it. Yeah. Exactly. That's why you should have looked better against C-Class. Some guys fight to level their opponents. And did you see Broner throwing cash at the Walmart workers? I saw Broner taking a dump. Do I think Broner's career is any good? No. Top three favorite fighters. Mayweather, Broner, Berto. My top three favorite fighters. I have to think about that. Broner needs footwork more than let his hands go. Broner needs to go with the Mayweathers. I think it would be good. Call out Floyd, seemed like he called out himself. Is Broner gay, Louie? I don't know. I don't know. From Texas, big shout out to Texas. Life is good. Just now jumping in here. It's been a while. Hello, Baylor. Hello, life is good. Anyone think that it was a bullshit stoppage? If you're a fan of Ashley Theophane and believe Ashley Theophane is going to win the fight, you probably think it was a bullshit stoppage. But if you knew Ashley Theophane was going to get his ass handed to him, then, you know, it was to be expected. Ken Taylor, AB versus TB. Yeah, we've been talking about it earlier. It's a fight that's definitely, I think, it's going to happen. I hate Broner, but shit makes me laugh. Yeah, I don't hate Broner. I dislike his antics. I think he's a wasted talent. I can't believe we're talking about Adrien as a wasted talent, but he is. But I wasn't a big fan of Ashley Theophane, to be honest, either. So I just, and two guys who I never were big fans of, Ashley Theophane and Ishe Smith. I give Ishe Smith a pass because he became world champion. Can Broner beat Andre Ward? Maybe on Fight Night Champion. I would have preferred at least a knockdown, though. Kell Brook, Manny Pacquiao, Amir Khan, Tim Bradley. I like Tim Bradley. I like Thurman. I like Sean Porter. I liked Garcia. After he fought Matisse, you can forget it. Don't like watching him anymore. What does Broner do in the welterweight division? Get his ass dropped again. I'm going to subscribe to your channel. Thank you very much. By the way, Baylor, I'm Bryant Jennings' friend from North Philly. Great job on your YouTube page, brother. You tell Jet Bryant when he gets a chance, pick up his damn phone. I would love to talk to the champ. It's not about talking to a man, you know, when things are going well for him. I'd love to talk to Bryant. I think he's a top man. And big heart, and I'd love to know what really happened with the Luis Ortiz situation. From what I understand, this is no excuses. I heard that his training was not good at all. He had 2 weeks to prepare, some rubbish like that. I heard, so I'd love to talk to him. Kovalev versus Ward, who do I think wins? If Ward can get on the inside, I think Ward can win. If Ward can't get on the inside, Kovalev's going to hurt him. Broner is too talented. Ronaldo 7-7. He's a talented fighter indeed. Who said? I just go back up the. People are storming the room now. People are storming the room. Damn. Sorry, people, if I'm not answering, it's because I've just got my room stormed. Are there much Hispanic fighters over in the English circuits? Not really, no. I think Camacho, Woody Camacho was one. Who do I think will win in the fight between Saunders, Eubank? Saunders. Ken Taylor, I can't believe AB lost the belt. That's crazy. Not really. If you think about it, sanctioning fees and the fact that he probably said, you know what, I ain't paying sanctioning fees and I'm moving up to 147. Tell with it. So there you go. That's what I think that is. And that would make, if he moved up to 147, then it's okay for Floyd to fight him, isn't it? Floyd ain't going to fight him at light welterweight, is he? So yeah, that makes sense. Life is good. Says, admittedly, I have changed my perspective a bit of the years. A few fights of Broner, I was overlooking some of the natural abilities to punch together and have a very slippery style. He's a good fighter, but think about it, he could do so much more if he was a dedicated fighter. I'm subbing. Thank you to those people who are subbing tonight. Appreciate your sub. I think Kovalev Ward is a great fight. Definitely a great fight. PBC needs to start putting on some meaningful fights. It's true. I'll definitely let him know, Jennings. Yeah, let him know. Please let Bright know, because I like the man. Got a lot of time for him. You know, as a human being, and he should know me by now. All the interviews we've done, I want to talk to Brian because I think he does talk a lot of sense. I like talking to Brian a lot. I'm new here. Caution Mod says I'm new here, but you sound cool and I'm subbed you. Yeah, man, keep it up, man. And I'm gonna tell all my homeboys to sub for you. You love boxing too, man. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Mr. Stevens says all the stats are on eWorkers sub. Can you explain it to me? I don't know what you mean by that. Game Freak 720 says everybody sub, LOL. Isaiah Falcon says subbing. You know what? I'm going to have to do more of these late nights. Good job, Baylor. Keep it up, champ. Over and out. Thank you much, Danny Alvarez. Yeah, for those of you who don't know, it's 5 a.m. in the morning in Ireland. All the UK. Tank is a beast. He is. But I don't like the way he's getting caught with those shots over the top. Who would be a next fight for Eubank? Not named Billy Joe Saunders. Andy Lee. That'd be a good fight. Why hasn't a fight with Khan and Brook? I said it before. If you go back and look at my video, I said Khan versus Brook would not happen. And I explained why. And I explained why when they had the head-to-head when they were in Sky Sports Studios. Never thought the fight happened. Sean Porter, Keith Thurman. Sean Porter. I think Keith Thurman only fights one way. If he can't get you out in the first couple of rounds, he reverts the guy onto back foot. And he doesn't like pressure. And if Kolata can walk him to the back him up to the ropes and hurt him, you can be guaranteed that Sean Porter will do damage. You should check out my interview with Sean Porter's father, Kenny Porter. Did you know Kenny Porter was in the corner of Keith Thurman in a couple of his pro fights? Kenny Porter knows Keith Thurman very well. Ward and Kovalev is a good match, but also has the potential to be very stylistically boring. But I like technical boring fights as a boxing fan. That won't be boring. Porter can't adjust. I disagree with you. Did you know that Porter beat Usyk as an amateur? Yes, he beat Andrade as an amateur. That's a couple of few good fighters that Porter beat as an amateur. Yo, who was the ref? Who seen the ref rub Ashley Theophane's nipple? No, Daffon Don, I did not see that. And I'm not replaying the video either to watch it, because I was falling asleep. And I kind of thank God that Broner brought the fight to an end. Wish he'd done it sooner. Speaking of the overhand right, Baylor, Ashley was catching Broner with the overhand right all night. Yeah, but he's always been susceptible to the overhand right. Broner has not improved or changed since the Maidana fight. So, who'd win between Deontay and Anthony? I don't know. But Deontay's got his handful against Povetkin. De Gale versus Stevenson at 175. Who wins? De Gale. Speed. And I think Stevenson's getting older. Life is good. Maidana was also throwing the overhand right. Broner, there you go. See? Can Broner Floyd happen? I agree. I think it can happen. Do you think Danny Garcia will catch a L being in the welterweight division? Absolutely. Life is good. I think that the TMT fighter was throwing the punch that landed so well on the patriarch, Mr. Money Mayweather, LOL. Overhand right, only way to catch the Philly shell. Yes, but you have to have some power throwing the overhand right. And Ashley Theophane didn't stand a chance. Yo, Baylor, I'm a pro. I'm trying to make it to the Olympics. Any amateurs, 3-4 rounds isn't enough to get set a gameplay. So the aggressor most of the time wins. Brooke exposed Porter. I didn't think Brooke beat Porter, to be honest with you. I really didn't. But, you know. Personally, I think Money May would take Broner's school if they fought. I do agree. I totally agree with you there. Lomachenko versus Walters. That fight doesn't look like it's going to happen. Lomachenko is far more skilled than Walters. Walters goes in with a puncher's chance. Lomachenko goes in with a boxer's chance and can punch. You've got a guy who can box and can punch versus a guy who can punch. Broner, B-class fighter, A-class mouthpiece. I agree with you there, James Lyons. Absolutely agree with you there. Yeah, I agree with you there. I still would love to know why Jennings took the fight against Ortiz. It didn't make any sense to me. Yo, Baylor, any advice to me on boxing? I need your advice, man. Please, thanks. Advice? Best advice you can get is to talk to someone like James Elibashir. He's a great person to talk to. James Elibashir, check out the interviews. I did an interview with him tonight on this channel. Check it out. But James Elibashir, he was, since 1975, carried the bucket for Muhammad Ali. I would suggest you talk to guys like that. Talk to the old school trainers. Old school trainers are the best trainers to talk to, like the old school trainers. Very few of them around. Ronnie Shields, James Elibashir, you know, Tommy Brooks. Old school. Talk to the old school guys. I feel Broner Theophane is more acceptable as an undercard fight. Agreed. Daff or Don, the great Canelo Khan. Canelo, man, come on. Who won, Broner? If Khan somehow beats Canelo, could pull off money fight? No. If Khan got past Canelo, be sure that Gennady Golovkin will be waiting in the wings. Berto Ortiz too, who cares? I'm not being rude, but who cares? Really? Really? There's so many good boxing bouts we can have in the world. We have to watch these two fight again. Broner won, stopped Theophane. Ali, Money, Floyd, Money, Mayweather's booty for 9.5 million. Rip Lady T. Are you a woman? Lauren Williams. Whoa. Laurel Williams. Okay, Laurel. Hi. Is Brooke the best welterweight at the moment? No. And will he fight GGG or just talk? The moment Brooke needs to sign with Heyman, the minute Brooke signs with Heyman, we'll find out if he's the best welterweight in the world. Jennings fights for position no matter the opponent. Money had to be right as well. That's true. How did he win? He stopped Theophane. A lot of people said it was a body, the body shot was low, but Theophane was getting rocked. Why did Mayweather quit boxing? I always wanted to know. I don't think he did quit. There's something in that retirement thing, though. Chad Dawson is coming back. Yes, I've heard that. Does Briggs Hay happen? Let me tell you something. If Briggs Hay happens, I think it's a great fight for the first couple of rounds. Briggs takes a great shot. Briggs punches extremely hard. And the first couple of rounds, he could chin any heavyweight in the world. First couple of rounds. Berto versus Ortiz is boring. Ortiz will come out charging as usual. Berto will underthrow total punches, and Ortiz is likely headbutt a few times. Save your money. I agree, life is good. If those of you who are probably looking at me, I look completely whack. It is 5:30 in the morning. I haven't been to bed yet, and I've watched Adrien Broner versus Ashley Theophane, and I thought it was a smart idea to come on here and do this video, and almost 70 viewers later, I'm still doing the video, so that's what's going on. What's your opinion on Terence Crawford? Check out my interviews, not on this channel, but Baylorick, B-A-Y-L-O-R-I-C. Type in Terence Crawford, Baylorick. There are two interviews there. I still believe that we've got the longest interviews with Terence Crawford still to this day. Check out the two interviews of Terence Crawford. This is before Terence Crawford, actually. The first fight was after he beat Prescott. The second interview I did was just as he was going to fight Ricky Burns. Check out those two interviews. I rate Terence Crawford highly. I just think that he needs to fight a puncher now at the higher weight division. Let's just see how he does. I like Broner, but he has no chance against Floyd. No chance. Absolutely. I totally agree with you. Please let me know where you're from, whether you're male or female, whether you're from the UK, America, wherever else in the world. Please let me know where you're from and how you know about this channel tonight. And if you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe. Some of these guys don't know shit about boxing, asking if welterweights are going to fight some middleweights. I'm in work, mate. UK. What? You're at work? Okay. Wow. Don't get caught, mate. I've got AB in this fight. Which fight? Bradley going to knock Manny out. Mate, no way. If anyone's going to get knocked out, it's going to be Bradley, because he's got Teddy Atlas in that corner. And Teddy Atlas is going to start making Bradley do things that he shouldn't be doing. And whereas his old trainer actually really cared for him, I think this trainer he's got in Teddy Atlas is the Teddy Atlas show. So Teddy Atlas is more care about himself and telling Bradley he's a flipping fireman. He's putting out fires. What kind of nonsense is that? I'm not a fan of Teddy Atlas in a corner shouting at a fighter. I think you've got 30 seconds to a minute to give very important instructions to a fighter. Shouldn't be cheerleading in the corner. And Teddy Atlas, I think he gets a lot of credit for not a lot. And I believe that Teddy Atlas is going to get Bradley knocked out in this fight against Pacquiao, because Bradley's going to do things that he shouldn't be doing. And that's it. What do I think of Rigondeaux? Great fighter, great footwork. A fighter that he is, he's a great fighter. If you look at his footwork, his everything, top fighter. He's a guy, if my son boxes, I would tell him to watch this guy, Rigondeaux. Great fighter, great fighter. Rematch your joke, 209 all day from Conor McGregor. Rematches, immediate rematches don't bode well for the guy who lost the first fight. And I don't know if McGregor can win the rematch. I would go with Diaz again. Sorry. Marky Bay, ain't nobody hit harder than life. Agreed. Good to see you there. Love the way Atlas screamed the fuck out of Bradley last fight. Yeah, well, that's chilling, like I said. Who between Mayweather and Cotto? Mayweather. Mayweather was won over Cotto already, and Cotto will never beat Mayweather. Bradley wins the first fight, Baylor. Always debate about this, Manny. Win the second fight, clearly. I told everybody, go back and look at my video on Baylorick. I predicted a majority win for Bradley in the first fight. That fight was a fix because it was a fix because I truly believe, in my opinion. If your stream is freezing, just refresh it. I truly believe that fight was fixed because Bradley came into that press conference with a sign with Bradley Pacquiao 2. You don't get Bradley Pacquiao 2 if you get knocked out, you got beat on points. So I think the fight was a fix. That's why I came to the decision. I think some fighters like Bradley need that G up sometimes. That same G up is the sort of G up that gets you to go out there and get yourself knocked out. Life is good lines. Are you kidding me? Pacquiao made Bradley look silly in the first fight. That was the worst decision this decade. Well, yes, I would agree there. Bradley versus Pacquiao, who wins? If Pacquiao loses, does he retire or does he win? Does he fight Vargas or Crawford? I've always thought that Pacquiao was a sacrificial lamb for Crawford. But it was something Mayweather said that was very interesting. Mayweather said to Crawford, Pacquiao is a fearsome puncher. You need to be careful. Now, you don't tell another fighter that Pacquiao hits hard unless you have some inside intel. Is Crawford's chin as good as he says it is? Is he getting rocked by big punches and sparring? Is that the reason why Crawford's not fighting big punches? We don't know. But for Mayweather to say that, it led me to think, interesting. What's your take on the Broner fight? I did speak earlier on about it. There's nothing really to say. You'll have to spool this video when it's finished uploading, spool it back to the start. And I've explained my thoughts on that. John Jones is the best fighter on the earth. He might well be, I don't know, but he's a damn good fighter. With a name Jones at the end, ain't a bad thing. I'm a Bradley fan, but Pac-Man last fight ever, good luck. Listen, Pacquiao made Bradley look silly in the second fight, and I don't see Teddy Atlas making him a better fighter. They make him a worse fighter. Baylor, exactly. That fight could have went anyway. Pac did nothing in the fight. No knockdowns, no cuts. Life is good. Babatunde, Frampton versus Cruz or Donaire, who wins? I'd rather see Frampton fight Donaire than Cruz, but Frampton, good fighter. Oh, you got me going. You guys got me going now. I'm getting warmed up. First, Bradley is very technically sound fighter, very compact, great jab, and good footwork, but he's reckless. Yes, he's reckless. He's even more reckless. He's even more reckless with Teddy Atlas. Teddy Atlas ain't going to get him to box. Do I box? I used to box. I used to train at the same gym. I was going to turn pro under Steve Robinson's old trainer, Steve Robinson, former WBO featherweight champion of the world. And my trainer trained the super featherweight champion of the world, who was Barry Jones, who now commentates for Box Nation. Hey, I'm finished at 7 a.m., bro. So you're okay, lol. You're finished at 7 a.m. I don't intend to be here at 7 a.m. Great talking with you, brother. I'll let Jennings know you need that interview. Yeah, let him know. Tell him to hook a brother up. David Haver, Shannon Briggs, who wins? Whoever clips who first. Theophane was never going to win that fight. No, he was never going to win the fight. Says, follow me on Snapchat, chap. J Cook CTC. I'm not on Snapchat, but I am on Instagram. I don't know how you asked how Mayweather knew Pacquiao could pack a punch when he fought him. No, I don't mean like that, Abs Jr. What I mean is that Mayweather said to Crawford that he punches hard. You know, that he needs to, because they were trying to get Crawford to fight Pacquiao. There's a big talk about why don't Garcia fight Bradley? That would be interesting. Yeah, that would be interesting. If Garcia wins to get his first loss, let him go fight Bradley. Bradley works so much. Yeah, that worked Garcia. Garcia is now just a guy with a left hook who takes a good shot. Garcia is nowhere near the fight he was when he fought Amir Khan. Since that Lucas Ortiz fight, Garcia's gone like that. Terrible. Terrible. Inza Ahmed says, mate, you're awesome. Thank you very much. Appreciated. You're awesome too. Awesomeness. Sees awesomeness. I love Briggs, man. Let's go, champ. Indeed. Did Adrien Broner fight? Yes, he did. And he won. Manny versus Floyd fight was a setup. I don't have a name. Right. I don't know. I'm not on the inside. I wouldn't know that. AB did good tonight. Yeah, he did good tonight. He did what he did to do. Who won, AB? Yes. Can Antonio Tarver beat David Haye? If he does beat David, I would love to see that fight. I'd love to see that fight when David Haye was just moving to heavyweight. I'd love to see that fight then. But I think David Haye's speed and power would have been a bit too much for Tarver. Unless he maybe got dropped by bloody Bernard Hopkins. Who do you think Floyd and Broner going to fight? I think they'll fight one another. Herrera beat Garcia, old news, but still relevant. Peterson did the same, just waited too late to get busy. Do I listen to Grime? I listen to a bit of it, but I've got to say old school garage for me. Deontay would kill Briggs. Well, if Briggs landed on Deontay, in the first two rounds, Briggs stands a good chance. What are the chances you think Floyd will fight again? And what, you know, just, yeah. Pac-Man 2, I can't see it happen, but I can see the Broner fight happening. I think Broner doesn't hit as hard as Pacquiao hits harder than Broner. Do you think Manny has been legit his whole career? That's a tough one. Has he been legit all his career? Where can I watch Adrien Broner fight right now? YouTube. Check it out. I'm getting overly, excuse me, just forgive me. I'm getting overloaded by questions. If I haven't answered your questions, because this is flooding. Where can you watch the post-fight conference? Probably YouTube. I don't have a name. Floyd doped off his head. Jay Cook called to conquer. Adrien beat the brakes off that boy. He did. But did anyone expect anything else? You think AB can beat Floyd? No. Categorically, no. Floyd wouldn't belittle himself by fighting Broner. Yes, he would. He wouldn't have fought Berto. It's good to see you doing live shows again. Who should Ward face next before he takes on Kovalev? Take it easy, bro. Berbatov? Berbatov? Maybe that'd be nice. Are you a fan of UFC and who's your best fighter? I do like UFC. I can't tell you that I'm a fan of the way UFC is going. The best fighting the best. I like the concept. I admire what the man from this country is doing in Ireland. Conor McGregor, I admire what he's doing. I think his ass will get whooped again by Diaz because his rematches. Immediate rematches never bode well unless Diaz has paid a lot of money to fall down. Diaz will whoop his ass again. Because I just don't think... I think immediate rematches never bode well for the guy that got his ass whooped the first time round. If there's a little time out and then they fight, I think then Conor stands a chance. But otherwise, nah, I think Conor gets his ass whooped again. Wilder, I like him, but I see some holes in his game that are concerning. Indeed, can't find it on YouTube. Well, I can't help you there at the moment. You want to fight? Do I want to fight? No, I don't want to fight. Why? Do you want to fight? How old are you? For them to be fighting at 170 again makes no sense. I agree with you there. I'm not a UFC expert, but I damn well know if I moved up two weight divisions and got my ass whooped, I would not be going back to the same place again and getting my ass whooped to be telling the guy to come move down in weight. Manny is washed. No one loves him right now. He drinks pee and he doesn't speak English. Losing endorsements. Everyone follow me at Instagram. How's life in Ireland? Better than England? Indeed, the Phantom. Indeed. You should do a stream for the McGregor fight. Well, Lil Wave said, Conor would bounce Nate head on the ground. Really? I would disagree with you there. As the last time I saw it, I saw Conor being quitting. I saw his straight left hand bouncing off Nate's chin. Was it Nate, you thought? Diaz? Yeah. Ward should fight from Farah cleverly or Bremer as preparations before he fights Kovalev. Not really. I'd love to see Ward fight cleverly, but listen, when you fight Kovalev, it's like a minefield. And every time you take a step forward with someone like Kovalev, click bang, he take you out. I don't see how Fontfara or Cleverly or Bremer, none of those three guys there have. I'd like to see Ward fight Bremer and win a version of the light heavyweight championship. I mean, Bremer is a funny dude. That dude's been champion for so long. How comes he's never come to America and made any defenses of that title? For anybody that I ever know. Jay Cook called to conquer says, Canelo would wash Khan. Khan ain't got enough heart. Life is good says, UFC equals true form of fighting dumbass. Conor would win as long as he doesn't play groundwork with Diaz. Okay. Not throwing punches like a kid. Manchester says, Chisora versus Pulev if he wins. Good question. How much has Chisora got left? How much has he got left? That's the question. Back to boxing. If Chisora fancies it, it'd be a good fight. But I don't think people should sleep on Pulev. I thought Pulev is a great fighter. You're a dumbass. That's nice to know. But you're a dumber ass than me. Do you want to know why you're a dumber ass than me? Because I can just put you on timeout. Bye. Would you smash Holly Holm? No. Have you seen my wife? She's American. She came third runner-up worldwide. Beauty pageant. Yeah. Nah. I wouldn't smash Holly Holm. She has a vice for a... Well, okay. Do you know? I don't know that. I don't know. Where are we? Anybody else? 57 people in the room. Any other questions you're going to throw at me? Let me think. I think Wavy was calling the guys bashing UFC dumbasses, LOL. Even though the fight was stopped early, Adrien would have still won. No, he called me something as well. Called me a dumbass, which I didn't appreciate very much. Not at 4 o'clock in the morning. Misha Tate Toe. Yeah, Misha's quite decent looking lady, but can't beat the wife. For those of you who know me, know what I'm talking about. Charles Martin, Anthony Joshua, not even mentioned. I did talk about it early on. Where have I landed? Are we talking about heavyweights as well? Not my favorite weight class. Oh, well. Yeah, I did. I did talk about it. Someone asked about Khan Canelo above, but you didn't answer. Yeah, because I did answer Khan Canelo. I answered the question. I said that I don't see how moving up in weight improves your chin. Because if that was the case, Khan got chinned by Garcia. He got dropped by Diaz. He got rocked by Algeri. So was he moving up in weight? His chin's going to get better? No. Is he going to be a better box? Is he going to be faster moving up to middleweight? No. Is he going to have a better inside game moving up to middleweight? No. Is he going to be able to? No. Just no. Not no. No. Khan's going to get hurt by Canelo. Mid to late rounds, say 6 rounds onwards. I can see maybe starting. I'll try to start off fast, but you know, just look. Khan hasn't fought for what, a year, almost a year. I told everybody I think it's a cash out fight. I think Khan's wanted to cash out for ages. Go back and look at my videos on that Nate tape. I would make her face look like plaster radio. Please, Khan, beat Canelo. I used to dislike your glass chin. Now I'm anti-hero, rooting for you to stop Canelo. LOL. Do you listen to Future? Future? Do you think Robert Easter Jr. can be successful further on? Listen, he lands that right hand like that on any of the top boys. Interesting. Who won? Is AJ the next title holder? Well, if he beats Martin, he would be. I don't see him beating Martin. Will Fury be KO'd? Well, if he gets hit with the right punch by the right guy, then maybe. How do you feel about the Black Lives Matter movement? Ooh, we're getting political tonight. I'm not in America, so I can't speak for that point. I think all lives matter. I think there certainly has been injustice to a race of people. I think, but injustice, regardless of colors, injustice, whether you be black, white, green, yellow, purple, orange. But the political situation in America is very heightened, and people feel they've got something to voice their opinions on, and feel rightly so, in the way they're being treated by the police, and people being killed necessarily. So who am I to say this or that? Carly's moving to going to middleweight. I thought he was going to welterweight. Ouch. Odds are heavily against him. No. He's moving up to. Is it better there? Where? In Ireland? Yeah, it's cool. Ireland's cool. Anyone want to buy me pay-per-view? No. Get a laptop and stream free. I'm not a Fury fan, but I do like his bizarre, awkward methodology of being elusive. Good movement for a big guy. Very big, good movement for a big guy, indeed. Jay Cook, call to conquer. I hope that answers your question about the Black Lives Matter movement. Interesting question. Ill Wavy, Trump for 2016. Okay, fair enough. If that's what you like, who am I to say this or that? Right. If there's nothing else pressing to discuss, I think we've talked about Canelo, I've talked about Joshua, I've talked about Broner. So I think that's about it. Come to 10 to 6 in the morning. Thank you all so much. While you're at it, please check out my interviews that I've done recently with Abel Sanchez, with Eddie Chambers, with Tyson Fury. There's two interviews I've done with Tyson. One a back and forth between me and him, and the other one talking about his thoughts on Anthony Joshua. Have a good day, bro. America is way better than England. It probably is, but is it better than Ireland? How do I feel about Andre Ward? I love Andre Ward. I think he's a great fighter. Doesn't get enough credit. I like a guy who can adjust, and he can definitely adjust. Did I go to Big Bear? No, but if I want to get to America, I will be going to Big Bear to seeing Abel Sanchez. What is America? Very good point. What is America? The land that belonged to Native Americans. That's what America is. Have a great day, brother. It's good that I found your channel. Hey. It's good that you found my channel. I'm sure you've been on my channel before. Don't forget to rate, subscribe, leave your comments, of course, as always. Earl Wavy is saying Trump, Trump, Trump. Yes, nice. I live 45 minutes from Big Bear. Ah, how do I feel about Victor Ortiz versus Berta 2? I mentioned that earlier on. Did NZRD stop him in the ninth round? Yes, he stopped him in the ninth round. Would I feel about Victor Ortiz versus Berta 2? Or wasn't greatly excited about the first fight. It was okay. But how comes Harry Grubb has not one recorded match and is considered top five all-time great? Don't know. I'd have to do more research on that one. Andre Ward is classy. That's why he doesn't get the attention he deserves. Do you agree? Yes. I totally agree with that. I love Ireland. I need to visit there. Take care. You're awesome. Inza, thank you so much. AB, America conquer the world. Yeah, well. I've got nothing against America. My wife's American. Victor Ortiz versus Brandon Rios, who wins. Now that's a fight I wouldn't mind seeing. I'll go Victor Ortiz because Victor's fresher. But about 5 years ago, yeah, I still got Victor Ortiz. At any time. Brandon Rios has got a big mouth, but he's a walking punching bag. So I've got Victor Ortiz. I'm trapped here in the US in a racially polarized, self-depreciation society ran by narcissists, gun lovers, warmongers, maniacal freaks. Okay, that's a discussion you're going to have on my other channel. I'm out. 36 from like almost 80 viewers down to 36 viewers. That means it's time to go. Thank you all so much for tuning in. Appreciate it. Check out the videos on the channel and please subscribe to this channel and subscribe to Baylorik, B-A-Y-L-O-R-I-C. If you're a Terence Crawford fan, check out the Baylorik channel. It's got 2 30-minute interviews with Terence Crawford, Keith Thurman interviews, Muhammad Ali's brother interview there. If you're more than boxing, you want to know a little bit more on Baylorik TV, I've done interviews also with Destiny Child's former manager. There's loads of interviews and stuff over there, so check it out. Right, I'm getting out of here. This has been Ingram Jones from Baylorik TV Boxing Channel, and I'm out. Have a good night. Leave America home. Right. Leave America home. Give a shout out to Kansas City, Missouri. Oh, yeah, shout out to Kansas. I'm out to too many Obama fans. Nope, I'm not leaving. Well, for those of you who missed out, do you rub Nutella on yourself every morning? No, I don't rub Nutella myself, but I love Nutella. Black is beautiful. Barry Obama, great. It's time to go now. I'm out. Why did Mayweather quit boxing? I always wanted to know. I don't think he did quit. There's something in that retirement thing, though. Chad Dawson is coming back. Yes, I've heard that. Does Briggs Hay happen? Let me tell you something. If Briggs Hay happens, I think it's a great fight for the first couple of rounds. Briggs takes a great shot. Briggs punches extremely hard. And the first couple of rounds, he could chin any heavyweight in the world. First couple of rounds. Berta versus Ortiz is boring. Ortiz will come out charging as usual. Berta will underthrow total punches, and Ortiz is likely headbutt a few times. Save your money. I agree, life is good. If those of you who are probably looking at me, I look completely whack. It is 5:30 in the morning. I haven't been to bed yet, and I've watched Adrien Broner versus Ashley Theophane, and I thought it was a smart idea to come on here and do this video, and almost 70 viewers later, I'm still doing the video. So that's what's going on. What's your opinion on Terence Crawford? Check out my interviews, not on this channel, but Baylorick, B-A-Y-L-O-R-I-C. Type in Terence Crawford, Baylorick. There are two interviews there. I still believe that we've got the longest interviews with Terence Crawford still to this day. Check out the two interviews of Terence Crawford. This is before Terence Crawford, actually. The first fight was after he beat Prescott. The second interview I did was just as he was going to fight Ricky Burns. Check out those two interviews. I rate Terence Crawford highly. I just think that he needs to fight a puncher now at the higher weight division. Let's just see how he does. I like Broner, but he has no chance against Floyd. No chance. Absolutely. I totally agree with you. Please let me know where you're from, whether you're male or female, whether you're from the UK, America, wherever else in the world. Please let me know where you're from and how you know about this channel tonight. And if you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe. Some of these guys don't know shit about boxing, asking if welterweights are going to fight some middleweights. I'm in work, mate. UK. What? You're at work? Okay. Wow. Don't get caught, mate. I've got AB in this fight. Which fight? Bradley going to knock Manny out. Mate, no way. If anyone's going to get knocked out, it's going to be Bradley, because he's got Teddy Atlas in that corner. And Teddy Atlas is going to start making Bradley do things that he shouldn't be doing. And whereas his old trainer actually really cared for him, I think this trainer he's got in Teddy Atlas is the Teddy Atlas show. So Teddy Atlas is going to more care about himself and telling bloody Bradley he's a flipping fireman and he's putting out fires. What kind of nonsense is that? I'm not a fan of Teddy Atlas in a corner shouting at a fighter. I think you've got 30 seconds to a minute to give very important instructions to a fighter. Shouldn't be cheerleading in the corner. And Teddy Atlas, I think he gets a lot of credit for not a lot. And I believe that Teddy Atlas is going to get Bradley knocked out in this fight against Pacquiao, because Bradley's going to do things that he shouldn't be doing. And that's it. What do I think of Rigondeaux? Great fighter, great footwork. A fighter that he is, you know, he's a great fighter. If you look at his footwork, his everything, top fighter. He's a guy, if my son boxes, I would tell him to watch this guy, Rigondeaux. Great fighter, great fighter. Rematch your joke, 209 all day from Conor McGregor. Immediate rematches don't bode well for the guy who lost the first fight. And I don't know if McGregor can win the rematch. I would go with Diaz again. Sorry. Marky Bay, ain't nobody hit harder than life. Agreed. Good to see you there. Love the way Atlas screamed the fuck out of Bradley last fight. Yeah, well, that's chilling, like I said. Who between Mayweather and Cotto? Mayweather. Mayweather was won over Cotto already. And Cotto will never beat Mayweather. Bradley wins the first fight, Baylor. Always debate about this, Manny. Win the second fight, clearly. I told everybody, go back and look at my video on Baylorick. I predicted a majority win for Bradley in the first fight. That fight was a fix because I truly believe, in my opinion. If your stream is freezing, just refresh it. I truly believe that fight was fixed because Bradley came into that press conference with a sign with Bradley Pacquiao 2. You don't get Bradley Pacquiao 2 if you get knocked out, you got beat on points. So I think the fight was a fix. That's why I came to the decision. I think some fighters like Bradley need that G up sometimes. That same G up is the sort of G up that gets you to go out there and get yourself knocked out. Life is good lines. Are you kidding me? Pacquiao made Bradley look silly in the first fight. That was the worst decision this decade. Well, yes, I would agree there. Bradley versus Pacquiao, who wins? If Pacquiao loses, does he retire or does he win? Does he fight Vargas or Crawford? I've always thought that Pacquiao was a sacrificial lamb for Crawford. But it was something Mayweather said that was very interesting. Mayweather said to Crawford. Pacquiao is a fearsome puncher. You need to be careful. Now, you don't tell another fighter that Pacquiao hits hard unless you have some inside intel. Is Crawford's chin as good as he says it is? Is he getting rocked by big punches and sparring? Is that the reason why Crawford's not fighting big punches? We don't know. But for Mayweather to say that, it led me to think, interesting. What's your take on the Broner fight? I did speak earlier on about it. There's nothing really to say. You'll have to spool this video when it's finished uploading, spool it back to the start. And I've explained my thoughts on that. John Jones is the best fighter on the earth. He might well be, I don't know. But he's a damn good fighter with a name Jones at the end. Ain't a bad thing. I'm a Bradley fan, but Pac-Man last fight ever. Good luck. Listen, Pacquiao made Bradley look silly in the second fight. And I don't see Teddy as making him a better fighter. They make him a worse fighter. Baylor, exactly. That fight could have went anyway. Pac did nothing in the fight. No knockdowns, no cuts. Life is good. Babatunde, Frampton versus Cruz or Donaire, who wins? I'd rather see Frampton fight Donaire than Cruz, but Frampton, good fighter. Oh, you got me going. You guys got me going now. I'm getting warmed up. First, Bradley is very technically sound fighter, very compact, great jab, and good footwork, but he's reckless. Yes, he's reckless. He's even more reckless. He's even more reckless with Teddy Atlas. Teddy Atlas ain't going to get him to box. Do I box? I used to box. I used to train at the same gym. I was going to turn pro under Steve Robinson's old trainer, Steve Robinson, former WBO featherweight champion of the world. And my trainer trained the super featherweight champion of the world, who was Barry Jones, who now commentates for Box Nation. Hey, I'm finished at 7 a.m., bro. So you're okay, LOL. You'll finish at 7 a.m. I don't intend to be here at 7 a.m. Great talking with you, brother. I'll let Jennings know you need that interview. Yeah, let him know. Tell him to hook a brother up. David Haver, Shannon Briggs, who wins? Whoever clips who first. Theophane was never going to win that fight. No, he was never going to win the fight. Says, follow me on Snapchat, chap. J Cook CTC. I'm not on Snapchat, but I am on Instagram. I don't know how you asked how Mayweather knew Pacquiao could pack a punch when he fought him. No, I don't mean like that, Abs Jr. What I mean is that Mayweather said to Crawford that he punches hard, you know, that he needs, because they were trying to get Crawford to fight Pacquiao. There's a big talk about why don't Garcia fight Bradley? That would be interesting. Yeah, that would be interesting. If Garcia wins to get his first loss, let him go fight Bradley. Bradley works so much. Yeah, that worked Garcia. Garcia is now just a guy with a left hook who takes a good shot. Garcia is nowhere near the fight he was when he fought Amir Khan. Since that Lucas Ortiz fight, Garcia's gone like that. Terrible. Terrible. Inza Ahmed says, mate, you're awesome. Thank you very much. Appreciated. You're awesome too. Awesomeness. He's awesome, miss. I love Briggs, man. Let's go, champ. Indeed. Did Adrien Broner fight? Yes, he did. And he won. Manny versus Floyd fight was a setup. I don't have a name. Right. I don't know. I'm not on the inside. I wouldn't know that. AB did good tonight. Yeah, he did good tonight. He did what he had to do. Who won, AB? Yes. Can Antonio Tarver beat David Hay? If he does beat David, I would love to see that fight. I'd love to see that fight when David Hay was just moving to heavyweight. I'd love to see that fight then. But I think David Hay's speed and power would have been a bit too much for Tarver. Unless he maybe got dropped by bloody Bernard Hopkins. Who do you think Floyd and Broner going to fight? I think they'll fight one another. Herrera beat Garcia, old news, but still relevant. Peterson did the same, just waited too late to get busy. Do I listen to grime? I listen to a bit of it, but I've got to say old school garage for me. Deontay would kill Briggs. Well, if Briggs landed on Deontay, in the first two rounds, Briggs stands a good chance. What are the chances you think Floyd will fight again? And what, you know, just, yeah. Pac-Man 2, I can't see it happen, but I can see the Broner fight happening. I think Broner doesn't hit as hard as Pacquiao hits harder than Broner. Do you think Manny has been legit his whole career? That's a tough one. Has he been legit all his career? Where can I watch Adrien Broner fight right now? YouTube. Check it out. I'm getting overloaded by questions. So if I haven't answered your questions, because this is flooding. Where can you watch the post-fight conference? Probably YouTube. I don't have a name. Floyd. Should be live in a couple of seconds. Just right. Okay, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, where you are in the world. My name is Ingram Jones, and here we are, just the post-fight for... Hold on, let's fix that. That's not right. That's better. Don't know what happened there. Right. The post-fight video for Broner versus Ashley Theophane. Few things coming into this fight. I think everyone knew about Ashley Theophane and the Broner fight in terms of everyone's making a big fuss about Broner not making the weight. You know, I am not surprised in the slightest when it comes to Adrien Broner. He seems to be a law unto his own self. But everyone seemed to be shocked that Broner was going to not make the weight. I mean, let's be honest, apart from the outside dramas to this fight, in Broner's life otherwise, to be honest, there wasn't really much interest in this fight. You know, the play between Broner and Floyd Mayweather, let's also be honest about that, that's been going on for quite a while now. They had to build some sort of beef between the pair of them, the beef between Berto and Mayweather. Whether it was real or not, I don't know. But Andre Berto has got paid well. As for now, this storyline between Adrien Broner and Floyd Mayweather, it's been a story that's been building a while. You know, they're best of buddies. They're, you know, little bro looks up to big bro. And then Broner's done a few things that big bro has not been really, you know, hasn't taken kindly to. I mean, big bro himself isn't really exactly the role model, but anyway, it is what it is. We get previews to what happens in fights now, because boxing is in such a poor, not a great state at the moment, that we have to have these fake rivalries and fake grudge matches And then we wonder why we don't get the intensity that, and people are disappointed because it's not real. But anyway, I digress. Ashley Theophane, no disrespect to Ashley. He's a basic fighter. And again, no disrespect, respect any man that gets in the ring and boxes. But to be really honest, I never understood why he was in TMT camp. I didn't understand why I was in a TMT camp then. I don't know why he's in the camp now. And I'm not sure what he'll do in the camp later. Never thought he was a good fighter. I thought he was a decent fighter, just a decent fighter. But I never knew why he was in the camp. Maybe made for good sparring, but you know, there was no way in absolute hell that Ashley Theophane was going to win the fight. There was no way that Ashley Theophane was going to beat Adrien Broner. Absolutely no way. You know, first of all, Theophane doesn't hit hard enough. And then secondly, you know, every time Adrien wanted to hit him, he was there to be hit. So he's a very basic fighter. Just basically, Broner was sucking it up, taking what he had to take on the gloves, and then when ready, unloaded the punch that he did. Yes, I admit it definitely was a low blow that he hit Theophane with. Definitely was a low blow, but you know, the writing was on the wall, and Broner did the job and stopped the fight. You know, he's talking about, you know, he's gonna have to come and see me, and you know, either we have a spar or we have a, you know, a fight. But come on, if you're really that much of a bad man, you have to wait until, you know, Floyd Mayweather was right there over the, on the ring apron. He said, oh, you're gonna have to see me. I mean, he just didn't see, he just seemed all choreographed, and even Floyd's looking at him and laughing and smiling and clapping as if to say, okay, let's see if you can hype this fight, let's see how much you can hype this fight. You know, that's what he's looking at, and laughing and smiling at him. You know, because all Floyd's looking at is money. My 50th fight. Who can I make the most money out of for my 50th fight? You know, who can it be? Can it be Pacquiao? Can it be Broner? Can it be Danny Garcia? Well, three of them. You know, Pacquiao hits the hardest between the three of them. Then you've got Danny Garcia, who's got a left hook but flat-footed. Then you got Adrien Broner. You know, Broner's flat-footed himself. He's undisciplined, and he's easy to hit. So, you know, you've got the Danny Garcia fight. But once you take the left hook away from Danny Garcia, and he doesn't even look that good at welterweight. So out of the three fights, you know, of the three guys who would sell a fight, Broner's the guy that would sell a fight for a 50th fight. Flat-footed, big mouth, you know, always talked about Mayweather versus Broner, what would happen. So there, you got your fight there. So there's your 50th fight. You know, even it makes me even wonder. I go back to think about the Maidana fight, the first fight of Floyd. He didn't have to sit on the ropes against Maidana, you know, and stand and go toe-to-toe with Maidana. In the second fight, he made the fight pretty easy. Kind of wonder, well, the first fight, did he say, yeah, I can get two fights out of this guy. I can actually get two fights out of this guy. Get it close. I ain't getting it beat on the cards. And then have rematch the guy and then just completely outbox him. I don't know. So it is what it is. Let's see. We've got some people in the room. Wow, you're up late, says Terence Trump. Free Khabib says, nice, easy, 50 quid. 6-4 Broner KO, easy money. Definitely easy money. Sergio Jimenez says, no one is here, just me. Sergio Jimenez says, save your voice. Yemi Babantunde, good to see you, Yemi. Hi, Ingram, long time no see. Was this beef real between them? No. Boy, you need to cut it. Broner look crap, says Boxing Fan UK. Broner and Mayweather beef, real or manufactured? Absolutely manufactured. Absolutely manufactured. Sergio Jimenez, where are you from? Babatunde, where exactly are you from as well? Fikabi, good to see you in the room. It was all BS, absolutely all BS, totally BS. I mean, you know, it is what it is. That if good to see you. Broner should join TMT. Yeah, he probably will. He probably will afterwards. And then, you know, Broner could be the head man for TMT after Floyd retires. For the, I don't know how many time. California. Big time. Love Cali. Love Cali. Spend time out there. Santa Monica. Spent a lot of time in Santa Monica. Loved it out there. Orange County. Lovely. Manufacturer setup for Mayweather's big 50th return fight. Yeah, of course. In what's your prediction tomorrow night, please? Smith is a cert, but Fielding with Brass could be a decent fight. It's, what can I tell you? Callum Smith, he's all right. I mean, I expect him to beat that guy. As for Rocky Fielding, I don't know. I don't rate his trainer very highly. But, I mean, where Brass just comes forward in straight lines. He's like a walking punch bag. What can I tell you? I don't know. I don't know. Fielding's decent, he'll beat Rabras. Fielding's a pretty decent fighter, and he punches pretty hard. His chin was shocking. I don't think Callum Smith, I know Callum Smith's a good puncher. Well, I wouldn't say he's a magnificent puncher, and Fielding got chinned in a round by Callum Smith. So, and I won't say Rabras is a big puncher. I'm from the UK, like you, Ingram, from Lancaster. Okay. Lancaster, nice. Okay, yeah, I'm actually living in Ireland at the moment, not the UK, but I hail from the UK in the beginning. Yeah, so yeah, I'm not totally, you know, I can't tell you that I'm a Broner fan, because I'm not. I think the guy could be three times a better fighter, but it's just the way it is for him. He's doing what he's doing. He might say about billions. I can't see him being a billionaire, to be honest. But I don't know what his court case is or what his situation is with him. I really haven't looked in it. I don't particularly care. To be honest, I don't like Adrien Broner because of what he represents. But to be absolutely honest, I didn't care for Theophane either. It does nothing for me as a fighter. You know, I think actually Theophane's a good fighter. He's a decent fighter, but. I mean, what was the stoppage like, James Hay? You know, Austin Broner, Brooke for big fight. Eddie keeps on about, Eddie will talk about anything. Eddie Hearn, as far as I'm concerned, cannot deliver the big fights. Not for Kell Brook, sorry. For him to deliver the big fights, he has to make Kell Brook. Kell Brook has to sign for Al Haymon. I've been saying this for donkey's years. He has to sign with Al Haymon. Eddie Hearn talks a lot, but I don't think he has the, let me say this way. It's not he hasn't got the budget. I don't think that Matchroom's investments in boxing are as much as people think it is. So what round? Round 9. Thank you, Lance, for that. So, no, I don't think Eddie Hearn can deliver the big fights, the really big fights. Don't think he can. The British fighters, yeah, but when you go to the States and the US fighters, then, you know, they might have paid a bit of money for Martin to come to the UK, you know, but that's it. That's going to be an interesting fight itself. There's no guarantee that Anthony Joshua walks away world heavyweight champion. Unless Mr. Martin's paid a lot of money, or Joshua finds a way to fight against Southpaw better than he did in the Olympics. So, yeah. What else for me to talk about? Nick Blackwell, I understand, is recovering. I believe I hear stories that he's actually okay. I just pray that he is. He called that Mayweather money. Will money Mayweather accept? It's easy money, isn't it? Did Broner deserve the win? Says Isaiah Falcon. Yeah. There was no way Ashley Theophane was ever going to win the fight, to be blatantly honest with you. He was never going to win the fight. Ashley Theophane versus Adrien Broner was like one guy who had a water gun and another guy who had a bullet in a gun. And that's what it was. Stoppage was a joke. Ashley was telling the ref about a low blow, not saying to stop the fight. I agree with that point. Definitely, JA One, I agree about that. But what I will also say is that Theophane would have been stopped. It was only a matter of time he would have been stopped. Every time Broner connected cleanly on Theophane, it looked like he could stop him. I couldn't stay awake, says Benjamin Berger. Yeah, well, I understand. I was kind of falling asleep as well. The fight was still over. Yeah, I agree, Lance. The fight was definitely over. I was still kind of falling. I was just dropping off watching that. Earlier on in the night, I liked Easter. He looked pretty tasty, that right hand. Very tasty, right hand. Looked good. And the guy before that, I think he's got 15 knockouts. He looked pretty decent. The only thing I was concerned about him, if somebody can give me his name again, the poor lad is... It's boxing fix. It's not the same anymore. Well, Ashley was getting beat back. Yeah, he was. Let's be honest. Issa did look good. The guy before that, the puncher, could please somebody give his name, the gentleman's name again. Is it Javonte, wasn't it? What do you make of the Mayweather prospect? Reminding me of Gamboa. Which one, Javonte? Yeah, I'm just talking about him now. I liked him. Seems to have good punching power. If I was correct, he was Javonte Davis. Thank you very much. Was he southpaw? God knows, I'm tired now. He was southpaw. He seemed to do little things like Mayweather, his back foot was there, his right hand. Javonte Davis, thank you. The straight right hand looked good. The points I liked about him is he's heavy-handed. He knows how to finish. The uppercuts, the way through uppercuts reminded me of Mike Tyson. Remember Mike Tyson when he fought Bruno for the second time round? He looked really good then when he was able to get into position and kept throwing the uppercuts. That was really sweet. I like that. And he threw three uppercuts, one, two, three at the end. That was nice. Takes a certain amount of class to get a man when you've got him hurt to throw three uppercuts like that. That was very, very nice. I like that. Liked his punch power. Looked very good like that. Javonte, for me, Davis, I like him. What I didn't like is that he kept getting hit with shots. That's what concerned me. He kept getting hit with right hands, and you just think to yourself, well, okay, you're doing that against lower level opposition and taking them out. That's nice. But you're still getting, he hit him nine times before the stoppage. And he kept getting hit with the right hand. So my concern with that is that he, good prospect, I don't like the way he's getting caught with the right hand over the top. And it's okay getting caught with the right hand over top against guys who can't punch. But when you get caught like that against a guy who can punch, there's a concern. Adam Scott says, shit, that it wasn't televised in the UK. It could have watched it live on Spike TV. It was online, but you could have got it, watched it online stream. Lance Easton said he hit him nine times before the stoppage. Yeah, he did. Those three uppercuts were quite vicious, eh, Lance? Danny Alvarez asked Mayweather to come back and fight Broner. Ludicrous or possibility? Big possibility. It looks pretty obvious. I mean, the Berto fight looked obvious. Some beef came out of nowhere. They fought. And this Broner thing's been going on for a while. It'll be interesting to see now Broner's situation. You know, does he get put behind bars? Because obviously, if Davey gets put behind bars, that puts pay to any Mayweather fight. Or does somehow the other Broner situation get sort of sorted out? Nope, you're wrong, Baylor. What am I wrong about? Tell me what I'm wrong about. I saw the fight live, so what are we talking about here? Please. Are you talking about Broner versus Mayweather? Mayweather won't fight him. Do you stream the fights? No, I absolutely don't stream the fights. But if you look at my Twitter page, I did send the link out for the fight tonight. I don't stream it, but I do send the links out if people ask for it. If you don't know, check out Baylorick, B-A-Y-L-O-R-I-C. Boxing, B-O-X-I-N, all one word, Baloric Boxing on Twitter. And the big fights, generally, if people ask for a link, I will. I don't do the links myself. I just find the links online and add them. So if you want to see a live fight, then that's what happens. I do it that way. Yeah. Will GGG call out Ward? He certainly won't do that. I believe that GGG will stay at middleweight and will look to dominate the middleweight division. Myself and James Elibashir have said it. And if you look at his trainer, hey guys, when is the post-fight press conference? God knows, I don't know. And, you know, what is there to talk about? You know, Broner put a beating in Ashley Theophane. And like I said, it was like one guy coming to a gunslinging match with a water gun and another guy with a bullet. And any time he wanted to let the bullet go, he could do. Is the Mayweather curse real? LOL. Usyk is ducking the Braveheart Simmons. Must have watched the Camacho fight. I spoke to James Elibashir tonight. Funny man. Funny. I spoke to James Elibashir tonight. It looks like Usyk will not be fighting, according to Bashir. He will not fight again until the world title fight. He sees no point. Unless Usyk's promoters think otherwise. The Gamer Freak 720 says Floyd will beat AB because Floyd ain't human, man. Durham Bull says, Freak says that fight will never happen. Well, never's a strong word in the world of boxing. But I will tell you this much, Durham Bull. I said that Mayweather would fight Pacquiao. Call the year when Mayweather would fight Pacquiao. And people said to me, no, that fight ain't going to happen. I think the fight will happen. I really feel the fight will happen. Think about it. It's 55. Never say never, not in boxing, especially with a fight like that. Broner's flat-footed. I mean, he gets bullied at welterweight. And as you know, Floyd's fought right up at light middle. But I believe it'll happen. I believe the fight will happen. I believe that Broner, like explained early on, he's flat-footed. He's got a big mouth. So he'll sell the fight. And, you know, he's target practice for Floyd Mayweather. So Floyd just gets himself into shape. And then he just beats the crap out of Adrien Broner. Because he knows Adrien Broner. Terence Crawford versus Broner. Now, I don't see that fight happening. Can't see that fight happening, to be honest. That's taking candy from a baby. That's exactly what Floyd would do. Beaver Chops 08 says, I don't see Floyd Broner, man. Too easy. Really? Well, look, well, you wouldn't have thought Floyd would have fought Berto, would you? Floyd Berto? Come on. One fight that won't happen is Fury-Vlad rematch. Vlad is going to mess Fury around, then retire. Well, when I spoke to Fury, he looked in decent shape, despite what people were saying on the camera. I sat down and spoke with him in a cafe at Wembley when his cousin Hugh was fighting. So it was me, Peter, Tyson, well, the whole of Team Fury, and myself in EJ Boxing. We sat down in a cafe and a long chat with Tyson. I think the fight will happen. Spence versus Broner, perhaps, but not Mayweather. No, don't think so. Berto was a bum. No, he wasn't a bum. I wouldn't say Berto was a bum. Berto was a good champion. Not great, good champion. Moving forward, Garcia versus Canelo or Khan 2. Depends on the winner or Garcia versus Broner options. I think Garcia fights Mosley. I think Mosley going to be fighting for the world title soon? I don't know. But it seems to me Garcia, as long as his dad is in control and he doesn't have any mandatories, he'll be fighting a lot of hand-picked opponents. That's where I think they're going to be. RC 513 says, obviously Floyd is more accurate and would probably at point A be easy, but I think Broner has more power and could be maybe make it interesting. Has AB got more power than Berto? I would argue that one. Berto's physically a bigger man at welterweight, a natural welterweight, whereas I think AB started his career at lightweight. Shannon Briggs be like, let's go, champ. Beaver Chops 08 says, well, see, though, apparently Broner got some big charges to get through first. Good point. Beaver Chops says, I enjoyed your Fury interview, mate. Thank you very much. What are your predictions for Amir Khan versus Canelo Alvarez? Well, you know what? Weight doesn't make you a better boxer. In the sense, it doesn't make you technically a better boxer. So my thoughts on Canelo Alvarez versus Khan is this. You can be a fan of somebody as much as you want. That doesn't help them have a better inside game. It doesn't help them take a punch any better. And it doesn't help them certain habits. Amir Khan has. Khan doesn't know what to do. He panics when a guy is able to get on the inside of him. You look at the Mark Peterson fight. You look at the Maidana fight. Look, these are guys that all, you know, Maidana isn't the fastest guy in the world, right? And Maidana was able to catch up to Khan and hurt him. I don't know. From Texas, big shout out to Texas. Life is good. Just now jumping in here. It's been a while. Hello, Baylor. Hello, life is good. Anyone think that it was a bullshit stoppage? If you're a fan of Ashley Theophane and believe Ashley Theophane is going to win the fight, you probably think it was a bullshit stoppage. But if you knew Ashley Theophane was going to get his ass handed to him, then, you know, it was to be expected. Ken Taylor, AB versus TB. Yeah, we were talking about it earlier. It's a fight that's definitely, I think, it's going to happen. I hate Broner, but shit makes me laugh. Yeah, I don't hate Broner. I dislike his antics. I think he's a wasted talent. I can't believe we're talking about Adrien as a wasted talent, but he is. I wasn't a big fan of Ashley Theophane, to be honest, either. So I just... And two guys who I never were big fans of, Ashley Theophane and Ishe Smith. I give Ishe Smith a pass because he became world champion. Can Broner beat Andre Ward? Maybe on Fight Night Champion. I would have preferred at least a knockdown, though. Kell Brook, Manny Pacquiao, Amir Khan, Tim Bradley. I like Tim Bradley. I like Thurman. I like Sean Porter. I liked Garcia. After he fought Matisse, you can forget it. Don't like watching anymore. What does Broner do in the welterweight division? Get his ass dropped again. I'm going to subscribe to your channel. Thank you very much. By the way, Baylor, I'm Bryant Jennings, friend from North Philly. Great job on your YouTube page, brother. You tell Jeff Bryant when he gets a chance, pick up his damn phone. I would love to talk to the champ. It's not about talking to a man, you know, when things are going well for him. I'd love to talk to Bryant. I think he's a top man and big heart. And I'd love to know what really happened with the Luis Ortiz situation. From what I understand, this is no excuses. I heard that his training was not good at all. He had 2 weeks to prepare, some rubbish like that I heard. So I'd love to talk to him. Kovalev versus Ward, who do I think wins? If Ward can get on the inside, I think Ward can win. If Ward can't get on the inside, Kovalev's going to hurt him. Broner is too talented, Ronaldo 7-7. He's a talented fighter indeed. Who said, I just go back up the room. People are storming the room now. People are storming the room, damn. Sorry, people, if I'm not answering, it's because I've just got my room stormed. Are there much Hispanic fighters over in the English circuits? Not really, no. I think Woolly Camacho was one. Who do I think will win in the fight between Saunders, Eubank? Saunders. Ken Taylor, I can't believe AB lost the belt. That's crazy. Not really. If you think about it, sanctioning fees and the fact that he probably said, you know what, I ain't paying sanctioning fees and I'm moving up to 147. Tell with it. So there you go. That's what I think that is. And that would make, if he moved up to 147, then it's okay for Floyd to fight him, isn't it? Floyd ain't going to fight him at light welterweight, is he? So yeah, that makes sense. Life is good. Says, admittedly, I have changed my perspective a bit of the years. A few fights of Broner, I was overlooking some of the natural abilities to punch together and have a very slippery style. He's a good fighter, but think about it, he could do so much more if he was a dedicated fighter. I'm subbing. Thank you to those people who are subbing tonight. Appreciate your sub. I think Kovalev Ward is a great fight. Definitely a great fight. PBC needs to start putting on some meaningful fights. It's true. I'll definitely let him know, Jennings. Yeah, let him know. Please let Bright know, because I like the man. Got a lot of time for him. You know, as a human being, and he should know me by now. All the interviews we've done. I want to talk to Bright because I think he does talk a lot of sense. I like talking to Bright a lot. I'm new here. Caution mod says I'm new here, but you sound cool and I'm subbed you. Yeah, man, keep it up, man. And I'm gonna tell all my homeboys to sub for you. You love boxing too, man. Thank you very much, appreciate it. Mr. Stevens says all the stats are on eWorkers sub. Can you explain it to me? I don't know what you mean by that. Game Freak 720 says everybody sub, lol. Isaiah Falcon says subbing. You know what? I'm gonna have to do more of these late nights. Good job, Baylor. Keep it up, champ. Over and out. Thank you very much, Danny Alvarez. Yeah, for those of you who don't know, it's 5 a.m. in the morning in Ireland or the UK. Tank is a beast, he is, but I don't like the way he's getting caught with those shots over the top. Who would be a next fight for you, Bank? Not named Billy Joe Saunders. Andy Lee, that'd be a good fight. Why hasn't a fight with Khan and Brook? I said it before, if you go back and look at my video, I said Khan versus Brook would not happen. And I explained why, and I explained why when they had the head-to-head when they were in Sky Sports Studios. Never thought the fight happened. Sean Porter, Keith Thurman, Sean Porter. I think Keith Thurman only fights one way. If he can't get you out in the first couple of rounds, he reverts the guy onto back foot, and he doesn't like pressure. And if Colata can walk him to the back him up to the ropes and hurt him, you can be guaranteed that Sean Porter will do damage. You should check out my interview with Sean Porter's father, Kenny Porter. Did you know Kenny Porter was in the corner of Keith Thurman in a couple of his pro fights? Kenny Porter knows Keith Thurman very well. Ward and Kovalev is a good match, but also has the potential to be very stylistically boring. But I like technical boring fights as a boxing thing. That won't be boring. Porter can't adjust. I disagree with you. Did you know that Porter beat Usyk as an amateur? Yes, he beat Andrade as an amateur. That's a couple of few good fighters that Porter beat as an amateur. Yo, who was the ref? Who seen the ref rub Ashley Theophane's nipple? No, Daffon Don, I did not see that. And I'm not replaying the video either to watch it, because I was falling asleep. And I kind of thank God that Broder brought the fight to an end. Wish he'd done it sooner. Speaking of the overhand right, Baylor, Ashley was catching Broder with the overhand right all night. Yeah, but he's always been susceptible to the overhand right. Broder has not improved or changed since the Maidana fight, so... Who'd win between Deontay and Anthony? I don't know, but Deontay's got his handful against Povetkin. DeGale versus Stevenson at 175. Who wins? DeGale. Speed. And I think Stevenson's getting older. Life is good. Maidana was also throwing the overhand right. Broner, there you go, see? Can Broner Floyd happen? I agree. I think it can happen. Do you think Danny Garcia will catch a L being in the welterweight division? Absolutely. Life is good. I think that, the TMT fighter was throwing the punch that landed so well on the patriarch, Mr. Money Mayweather, LOL. Overhand right, only way to catch the Philly shell. Yes, but you have to have some power throwing the overhand right. And Ashley Theophane didn't stand a chance. Yo, Baylor, I'm a pro. I'm trying to make it to the Olympics. In the amateurs, 3-4 rounds isn't enough to get set a gameplay. So the aggressor most of the time wins. Brook exposed Porter. I didn't think Brook beat Porter, to be honest with you. I really didn't. I really didn't. But, you know. Personally, I think Money May would take Broner's school if they fought. I do agree. I totally agree with you there. Lomachenko versus Walters, that fight doesn't look like it's going to happen. Lomachenko is far more skilled than Walters. Walters goes in with a puncher's chance. Lomachenko goes in with a boxer's chance and can punch. You've got a guy who can box and can punch versus a guy who can punch. Broner, B-class fighter, A-class mouthpiece. I agree with you there, James Lyons. Absolutely agree with you there. Yeah, I agree with you there. I still would love to know why Jennings took the fight against Ortiz. It didn't make any sense to me. Yo, Baylor, any advice to me on boxing? I need your advice, man. Please, thanks. Advice? Best advice you can get is to talk to someone like James Elibashir. He's a great person to talk to. James Elibashir, check out the interviews. I did an interview with him tonight on this channel. Check it out. But James Elibashir, he was, since 1975, carried the bucket for Muhammad Ali. I would suggest you talk to guys like that. Talk to the old school trainers. Old school trainers are the best trainers to talk to, like the old school trainers. Very few of them around. Ronnie Shields, James Elibashir, you know, Tommy Brooks, old school. Talk to your old school guys. I feel Broner Theophane is more acceptable as an undercard fight. Agreed. Daff Don, the great Canelo Khan. Canelo, man, come on. Who won, Broner? If Khan somehow beats Canelo, could pull off money fight? No. If Khan got past Canelo, be sure that Gennady Golovkin will be waiting in the wings. Berto Ortiz too, who cares? I'm not being rude, but who cares? Really? Really? There's so many good boxing bouts we can have in the world. We have to watch these two fight again. Broner won, stopped Theophane. Ali, Money, Floyd, Money, Mayweather's booty for 9.5 million. Rip Lady T. Are you a woman? Lauren Williams, whoa. Lauren Williams, okay, Laurel. Hi. Is Brook the best welterweight at the moment? No. And will he fight GGG or just talk? The moment Brook needs to sign with Heyman, the minute Brook signs with Heyman, we'll find out if he's the best welterweight in the world. Jennings fights for position no matter the opponent. Money had to be right as well. That's true. How did he win? He stopped Theophane. A lot of people said it was a body the body shot was low, but Theophane was getting rocked badly. Diaz dropped him. People think, oh, well, Khan will move up in weight. And if he moves up in weight, then, you know, Khan's going to be okay. But you know what? At lightweight, he moved up to light welterweight. He got chinned by Garcia. He got chinned at lightweight. He got chinned at light welterweight. He got dropped by Diaz as he was moving up to welterweight. He got buzzed by Algieri. Now he's going to move up to Canelo, who was chinned James Kirkland. And I would say James Kirkland hits harder than Khan. So I don't know. I think that Khan could possibly win the early rounds, but I can't see him manhandling the bigger man. And I just think round six onwards, I think Canelo's going to get closer. Khan will tire. Canelo will get inside, land the left hook, and bang. Not to compare, but Berto beat Tim Bradley in amateurs. Berto's not a bum, just bad habits. Thank you very much for that. Are you into MMA or just boxing? Well, I'm into boxing. I can't tell you that I'm a big MMA fan. I can tell you that I'm enjoying watching MMA. You're seeing the best fight the best. But I certainly can get into it. Pete Kavis says, Fury called you out for saying Chisora would beat him. Did you think he was going to flip the table at any point? No, I didn't. We were bantering about that back and forth beforehand. He tried to call me out about it early on when we were walking to the cafe. And I'd done the interview with him, and he called me out about it again. So I said, if he calls me out about it again, I'll talk to him. Not many journalists or bloggers would stand toe-to-toe, not toe-to-toe, sit toe-to-toe with a heavyweight champion of the world and explain their point. My point in case is this. I said to him, the reason why I thought he would be beat by Chisora was because I felt he was vulnerable to the overhand right. And he got dropped by Cunningham, who was a blown-up cruiserweight, or blown-up heavyweight, or cruiserweight. He got dropped by Nevin Pajcek, and he got dropped by somebody else as well. But all the three fights he got dropped, he was at mid-range, and he was susceptible to the overhand right. And actually, Chisora had dropped Kevin Johnson, had dropped Malik Scott, and the overhand right seemed to be a punch that he was doing very well with. So I thought that'd be a brilliant punch to throw against Fury. And then he was even getting clipped by, if I was right, was he fight Joe Yabo? Was getting clipped by Joe Yabo, even clipped him as well. So I think to myself, okay, Chisora's got a chance if he can get inside. I remember watching the first fight with Chisora and Fury, thinking to myself, the second fight, if Chisora actually came in shape, it'd be a good fight. Chisora came in shape, and Fury said to me before the fight, I'm going to show you something. And what did he do? He turned southpaw and took the right hand completely away from Chisora. So, you know, and I said to him, look, I actually said that you'd beat Klitschko. He said, I didn't know nothing about boxing. So it was a bad call on Chisora beating Fury. But I said that the big one, Fury beat Klitschko. And I broke it down as to why he'd beat Klitschko. Didn't get a knockout, but I said he'd beat Klitschko, and he did. So that really closed that down. Sugar Shane, please retire, man. Yes. AB won't touch Floyd, says Lance Easton. That referee at the end was who was with AB versus Theophane, looked like the Pink Panther. Funny. MMA's like dogfighting. Can't beat McDonough, or what is his name? I'm sure with a body shop. Khan, for all everyone saying Khan is fast, McDonough is slow. And Khan made McDonough look like Roberto Duran. Okay. Speed, this is speed kills, but I don't believe, in my opinion, that he's going to have the speed against Canelo. I really can't. Early rounds, maybe. But Canelo, once he starts getting inside, Khan's going to have to keep him off for 12 rounds. Can't see it happening. What are your thoughts on AJ versus Martin next week? Well, the only way you can really look into this fight for me is you go back to the amateurs. And if you go back and you look at, everyone keeps talking about his Olympic gold medal. And I keep saying, if you go back to AJ's amateur career and his Olympics, at the Olympics, if AJ had fought anywhere in the world apart from London, he wouldn't be Olympic champion because his performances were not impressive. The previous Olympic champions, Audley Harrison or James DeGale, their performances, regardless where they were in the world, they'd have been Olympic champion because they boxed their opponents. They did the business. So I'm convinced that AJ will have problems with Martin's left hand, and Martin just doesn't throw a straight left hand. He throws a left hand over the top and drops his head and brings the left hand over the top, which would be very dangerous. Oh, very dangerous, very, very dangerous. So if Joshua, who was much lighter then, was struggling against a left hander, if him now bigger, being bigger now, so it's slower, is he still going to struggle against a left hand? So, you know, who's he been sparring against as well? Very interesting. I think you'll get more sparring for a right-handed than a left-hander. So it'll be interesting to see how he does. But I'm backing Martin for this one. I did see the gloves are off. and I almost practically fell asleep on it. It was so boring, so boring. Charles Martin, he seems a man that means business, and Joshua's just saying things he normally says. It's good. I think it'd be a good fight. I think it'd be a good fight. Have you seen the gloves are off with AJ Martin? See more personality in Fury's Batman costume. Yeah, I agree with you. What's going on with McDonough? He looks in terrible shape. He got a lot of money from Floyd for sure. You think Broner was out of shape today? He did look quite sort of chubby, didn't he? But I thought Broner looked, well, he looked okay. People shocked at McDonough being so fat, forgot Hatton blew up like that between almost every fight. That's true, Pete Khabib, very true. I'm an AJ fan, but those Martin odds are very appealing. They are indeed. Steve Bond says, stick a tenner on it, mate. Broner is leaving 140 because Terence Crawford owns the division. Make no mistake. Terence Crawford, if you haven't already, check out my interviews with Terence Crawford. I've got two interviews with Terence Crawford before people start talking about Terence Crawford. Very knowledgeable guy. Knows his way around boxing for sure. The only thing, my only criticism of Terence Crawford, since he's moved up, he hasn't fought any power punches. We'll see what he does against Victor Pistol. I want to see him fight against a power puncher for sure. And once he can fight against a power puncher, and does well against power puncher. But yeah, I'd like to see him do that. That's the final piece in the puzzle for me, for Crawford. Broner is leaving the 140 because Terence Crawford. Yeah, okay. Two thumbs up, B Pepper. I want to see Broner in a post-fight presser. Okay, I can't help you with that one, mate. If you want to do that, I guess just wait until maybe someone like Fight Hype or something loads it up. I can't help with that, unfortunately. Oh, 66. Oh, good number. Yeah. Broner needs to finish work at 140 still. Yeah, I think he does. The fight I'd like to have seen was Broner versus Burns. Ryan Williams, Broner was tired. Yeah, well, for a tired man, he put some punches together quite nicely there, Ryan Williams. But Theophane, he was never. Hi, Brandon Vegas. I didn't think he was tired. I just think he was letting Theophane punch or shoot his water gun. And then when he was ready, lock and load and shoot. Do I think Maidana should have won, but Mayweather won? No, really. Broner announced to his coach, family, and team that he's moving up. That tonight was his last 114. He's moving up. Okay, fine. So he's going back to welterweight. To do what? Glad I never bet on Ashley. What a waste of time. What a waste of... You tell me. You leave England and you're an average fighter. You go to America. You train with Floyd Mayweather's camp. And you come out still an average fighter. I don't understand why people actually believed that he was good enough. I just don't know what the fuss was with Ashley Theophane. Then people actually thought Theophane was going to win the fight. I said Broner was going to smash into bits. Hey, Jermani Edwards. Did I say the name right? Good evening, Jermani. James Lyon says Broner looked average at best. Well, his opponent was below average. I'd get knocked out by Errol Spence, most likely. Why did a referee stop the fight? Why? It was a low blow. Because Theophane was going to get knocked out. Amanda Conlon, who won? Broner? Yes, he did. Jermani. Am I saying the name right, Jermani? Jermani Edwards says Broner is a beast, hands down. BPBRT. The life. I don't know why that seems familiar. Broner needs to throw combinations and he will be a force. Yeah, he does. He will be. Yeah, Broner versus Broner versus Floyd, yes. Yeah, I think so. I think Broner was toying with what's his name, to be honest. If I'm brutally honest, Ashley Theophane had no business being a ring of Adrien Broner. Absolutely none. Yeah, I never saw the hunger from Ashley, and I agree, Broner's a different level. Yeah, 147 is a crazy division, and Broner won't crack the top 10. No, he won't. Yes, it's like the country. Jimani. Okay. Where are you from, Jimani? Which Hov 6 is AB? Anybody can get it. Yeah. Exactly. That's why you should have looked better against C-Class. Some guys fight to level their opponents. And did you see Broner throwing cash at the Walmart workers? I saw Broner taking a dump. Do I think Broner's career is any good? No. Top three favorite fighters: Mayweather, Broner, Berto. My top three favorite fighters. I have to think about that. Broner needs footwork more than let his hands go. Broner needs to go with the Mayweathers. I think it would be good. Call out Floyd, seemed like he called that himself. Is Broner gay? Lou Wei.